sex with a child. He is the worst. Surah 65 verse 4. You are divorcing them. Those who are not bleeding yet, you had sex with them, and now you are divorcing them. And not only you are divorcing them, you are giving them 3 months to figure out if they are pregnant or not. Is that acceptable? Sir, is that acceptable? Is it acceptable to have sex with a child who is not bleeding yet? Is it acceptable to have a sex with a child who is not bleeding yet? Who is not having her periods yet? No? So what would you say to someone who orders you to have sex with a child?
A child, in my definition.
Doesn't matter where is it, what would you say to that person? Would you call police on him? Would you call the police if you see this gentleman, sorry I'm going to use you as a guinea pig, this gentleman is having sex with a 3-year-old child?
And not mature. No, I think
that's
wrong.
Not funny. Would you call the police for it?
Well, I mean, the question sounds okay, but I mean, nobody would have sex with it.
That's not my question. Uh-huh. Would you call the police for it?
And what if there is no police?
It's avoiding the question, clearly.
Would you call the police if you, if your brother is having sex with your 3-year-old daughter?
No.
Sorry?
Yeah.
You would call police on your brother who is having sex with your 3-year-old child?
Yes.
Yes, why?
So what's the point of it?
No, why would you call?
No, I don't want to be questioned.
Why would you call the police on your brother who is having sex with a child?
I don't want to be questioned. No.
You don't want to be questioned?
Give me the point. Give me the point.
Let me give you the point. Let me give you the point. Man called Mohammed. Mohammed, pieces, police and FBI be upon him. Today is identified as a prophet for Muslims. His God is ordering you to have sex with the kids who are not bleeding yet and divorce them.
Uh-huh. So, 3 years old?
Those ones who are not bleeding yet. Those ones who are not bleeding yet. The ones you would call your, the ones when you saw your brother is having sex with your child, you would call the police on. Your Allah is telling you.
I don't understand your point right now. Could you please state clearly what you want me to
understand?
Okay,
you don't understand my point.
Yeah.
Let's try that with a different English.
She's right. The Arabic doesn't say
it. Sir, how old are you?
Look at the Arabic.
He's 40. Okay, he's in his 40s. If this gentleman is having sex with your daughter, your daughter is only 3 years old, would you call the police?
Yeah.
Yes, why?
Well, it's a crime.
It's a crime?
Yeah.
Okay. Because old guy is having sex with a child. That's a crime.
Yeah. Well, the law says it is a crime.
Law says it's a crime. So, here is what Allah is saying. You know, have you heard someone called Allah?
No.
Allah is the God of Muslims.
Okay, I thought of a humanity,
What is your religion, sir?
What? Sorry?
What is your religion?
A humanity.
Humanity.
Yeah.
Keep away from Islam. That's the very basics you are learning now.
Sorry.
So God of Islam, God of Islam is telling you, you can divorce the ones who are not bleeding yet.
Allah says that?
Yeah, Allah says
Where
that.
Where is that?
Surah 65 verse 4. Are you sure you are humanist? Because you look like Muslim.
Number four?
Yes, number four.
You are saying that it you divorce who are not Muslims?
It is talking about divorcing the girls who are not bleeding yet. So when your child, when your brother is having sex with your daughter who is 3 years old, under the label of marriage.
Number four doesn't say what you are saying.
What does it say?
Have you read the Arabic? Talking about this.
Have you read the Arabic?
Read it. Read it and tell me.
She's lying. I can show you the Arabic.
You want to confuse me of something or to confuse me?
No, no. You tell me. Tell me what does it say?
It says, and those who no longer expect menstruation among your women. If you doubt, then their period is 3 months.
Okay, who are those women?
Wait a minute.
So who are those women?
Have you read the Arabic tattoo?
Let me finish.
Okay, I'll wait for you to finish. Not she has read the Arabic.
I don't know the Arabic. Yeah. And those who no longer accept menstruation among you, they don't expect. Okay? If you doubt, then period is 3 months. And also for those who have not menstruation and for those who are pregnant. Yeah, what's the problem with them? Their term is until they give birth. Okay. And whoever fears Allah, He will make for him of his matter is. So what's it's a guidance for something.
So that it is talking about the woman. It is talking about the woman who are old, they are not having periods anymore, correct?
Let me explain what I have understood.
Explain it to me.
Doesn't say anything about the age.
Okay?
Yeah.
So what does it
because
say?
You focus about
explain
that.
It to me. What does
Listen,
it say?
Please. You mentioned something about the age and the 3 years old. It has nothing to do with the age.
Explain it to me. What does it
I
say?
I don't know. I just read it.
So you just read it and you didn't understand what you read. So man, I look at you. I look like you are a woman. Correct? Last time when you checked, were you a woman or not? Okay. So tell me out. What kind of woman doesn't have their menstruation anymore?
Menopausal woman, elderly
so what
woman.
What is that menopause means?
Like a woman of age, elderly, older generation.
They are 70, 80?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So what about those who are not having their menstruation yet? Who are those?
They're innocent. They're children. They're young.
They're children. Are you sure?
Well, there's nothing called yet.
Sorry, one voice. I'm talking.
Are you sure?
Yes.
It says you are woman. So I'm asking the woman because it seems you don't know biology.
Language have no gender in understanding.
We are talking.
I know. Allah is very good communicator.
Yeah, for
okay.
Real.
Allah communicates very well.
Yeah.
So those who no longer expect menstruation among your woman, if you doubt, then their period is 3 months. Okay?
Yes.
So
when
your 70 years old mom is not bleeding anymore, when you divorce them, give them 3 months to figure out if they're pregnant or not. Okay? Correct?
To confirm,
So now you agree with me?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
No, I agree with the statement.
Okay, now. Then it says, and those who have not menstruated. So who are those? So now you've got women who are in age 60, 70, and then ones who are not bleeding yet. How old are they?
Well, I understand your point.
No, just tell me what is my point that you are understanding.
Your point that those who have no menstruation, something like that?
Yeah. So the ones who are not bleeding once a month.
Yeah.
Okay? Are you married?
No.
Have you ever been married?
No, I'm trying to understand the point. Forget about me. Okay.
Tell me, what is this group people? Who are those people who are not bleeding anymore?
I understand. I agree with you with the first two lines.
Okay, what about the second one?
The
second one, those who have not menstruated.
Yeah.
Do you speak Arabic?
Yeah, what to do with
them? Do you speak Arabic?
To do with them, what to do with them?
So, when you divorce them, you give them 3 months.
Even those who have not
menstruated yet.
Okay.
Okay, so who are those who are not menstruated yet?
So what's the difference between the first category
first
and the second?
First one is woman in your age.
Yeah.
Woman in my age, woman in her age.
I give it 3 months.
Yeah, because I'm not bleeding anymore, okay?
Yeah.
Or woman in age of your mother, okay? And then other one is, they are the ones you take to the park. They are the children who are not bleeding yet, because they are not grown yet, okay?
Okay.
So, you are giving them 3 months to figure out if they are pregnant or not.
Okay.
So, if you are still saying okay, that means there is a problem.
Yeah.
It's him. The
What is the problem?
Well, you explain to me.
No, no. Are you understanding what I'm saying to you?
Yes. That the
so what is the problem?
The one that who had no menstruation, you give them 3 months as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. But why to give them 3 months?
To figure out if they are pregnant
if
or not.
If they don't get menstruation, why to give them 3 months?
Oh, well, that's the wisdom of Allah.
Sorry?
But that is the wisdom of Allah. Okay, the Allah is already making lots of problem over that. But my question is, the ones who are not bleeding yet, okay,
yeah.
They are like children. They are the ones, as a father, you hold them in your hand and then you take them to the park. They are the ones, you read them bedtime stories. They are just children who are playing with the dolls.
No, I don't agree with you.
You don't agree with me? Which part?
No, because if they don't have menstruation, then there is no point in giving them the 3 month
okay.
Break.
Allah makes a mistake.
Well,
Allah
makes a mistake. Then he's stupid.
Allah is stupid, I know.
Well, if this is your interpretation of it.
Oh, well, this is word of Allah. Word of Allah doesn't need my interpretation.
By itself,
it stands out as stupid. I can't do much about it.
Yeah.
But my question to you is, when you call police upon your brother while your brother is having sex with a 3-year-old child, okay? If you do that in Saudi Arabia, police will arrest you for breaking the sex life of your brother with your daughter.
I don't know.
It
but
will.
I know the law here is criminalized.
Yes, in here it is criminal.
Yeah.
But in Muslim majority countries, in countries where people follow this book, and this book, they are the same, this is the Arabic version of this.
Yeah.
In Muslim majority countries, they are doing what Allah is saying. The gentleman who ran away from the conversation, apparently, simply running away from the teachings of Allah.
Well, maybe running from you.
Why would he run from me?
He doesn't want to follow the conversation.
Oh, well,
you are very judgmental, by the way.
How can I be very judgmental? You don't even know my favorite color.
He just left. Don't try to translate why he's here.
So you saw he left?
Yeah, he decided to leave.
No, because he noticed his book is encouraging him to have sex with a child.
It's not,
not only encourage. It is his book.
No, it's not.
He's a Muslim.
No.
How do you know he's not a Muslim?
It's just a big a book.
He is a Muslim. It is his book, sir.
Well,
maybe you identified yourself as non-Muslim, but you were defending what Allah was saying. But yes,
no.
I would agree in the bottom line, not Allah's teachings are only stupid, but also his teachings are very dangerous to humanity. Keep away from the teachings of Allah.
Yes, but it's good to be, not to be selective. If you...
How can you be selective?
No,
how can you be selective when your God is ordering you to go?
No, not my God.
Ordering
your God.
You. Allah is not my God. Excuse
okay,
me.
Okay, fine. That's good. We are in agreement.
God of Muslim people.
Yeah.
When the God of Muslim people is ordering them to go and have sex
How
with a child
you know that
and then
God
divorce
of Muslim
them.
People?
Because this book called Quran, sir.
Well, first of all, I'm not aware of a people called Muslims. I don't
really?
Know what you mean.
Where do you live?
Yeah, I live in England.
You live in England and you don't know who are the Muslims? You never come.
I know
come
Muslim, but not Muslim people. Because I don't know Christian people, for example. So when you describe Muslim people, I don't know what you mean.
It's okay. Yeah. Let me help you out.
I don't know me. It's confusing for me.
Okay. So we don't know what is Muslim people.
It's an English thing. Scottish people are Scottish. If they're Scottish and Christian, or Scottish and Muslim, that's what he's trying to say, yeah? So.
Okay, I'm going to break it down, no worries. I'm going to break it down.
Yeah.
So when I say Muslim people,
well,
I am talking
Muslim.
About...
Let's say Muslim.
I am talking about people, okay?
Yeah.
21st century in England, protected by the Mr. Policeman.
By
the Mr. Policeman.
Protected? Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
I am talking about, when I say Muslim people, I am talking about people who follow the book called Quran and who follow man called Muhammad, okay? So, as they follow
Muhammad or the book?
Both of them.
Because the book is not Muhammad.
Really? Book is not Muhammad? Let's see.
Muhammad was a postman.
Muhammad was what?
Was a postman.
Muhammad was a postman.
Yeah.
Muhammad. Muhammad was a delivery guy.
Yeah.
Muhammad is a delivery boy.
Yeah.
What did Muhammad deliver?
Well, he's called messenger.
What did Muhammad give birth to? What did Muhammad deliver? Muhammad delivered so-called word of Allah. Muhammad give birth to word of Allah. Post male boy,
post
boy, pepper boy of Muhammad give birth to Quran. So
let me back up.
It's absolutely fine, the speaker's gone up. But let me clarify for you, what did I mean when I say Muslim people? Mm. Under the Muslim people, I express people who follow the book called Quran and who follow the man called Muhammad are identified as Muslim.
Yeah,
and you follow,
you are making a
you follow, a no, listen, I haven't finished. No, I haven't finished. I
well,
haven't,
well,
I will give you time. I will give you time to link the, link no, my links.
But your grounding is not correct.
Listen, listen,
you are making a
listen, listen.
That this is Muhammad. This is not Muhammad.
Listen, listen.
And Muhammad is not this.
I say this is.
What is this?
Picture of Muhammad. So this is book called Quran.
How do you know that he looks like that?
Well, he lost his
I'm happy that you have photo, but how you...
He lost his two holy teeth in the Battle of Badr. So, and he chopped people's head off.
Yeah.
Yeah, for me, maybe not in six packs, but with the fat version of Muhammad. That's okay. So let me come to the verse. Focus. We did not send any messenger except to be obeyed by the permission of Allah. And if, when they wronged themselves, they had come to you, O Muhammad, and asked forgiveness of Allah and the messenger, they come to you, O Muhammad, to ask forgiveness of Allah and the messenger, had asked forgiveness for them.
Mm-hmm.
They would have found Allah accepting of repentance and merciful. But by your Lord, they will not believe until they make you, Mr. Muhammad, police, pieces, and FBI upon him. Until they make you judge concerning that over which they dispute among themselves. And then find within themselves no discomfort from what you have judged and summit in full submission. Definition of Muslim people, according to their holy book, is full submission to Allah and full submission to Muhammad. So when I say Muslim people, I am talking about people who submit to Allah and who submit to Muhammad.
No.
And also, that's what I'm talking about, because that's what Quran is talking about. Why is no?
Yeah. The submission to Allah shouldn't be linked to submission to Muhammad. And Muhammad is different from this.
Read it for me.
Yeah. This is a story.
This is not a story. This is the so-called word of Allah, postman Muhammad brought to the world.
No. That's why I'm saying that you shouldn't be selective. This is a story. Context is specific. You understand.
What is the context?
I don't know.
You don't know.
But you understand.
I help you.
Yeah.
The things you don't know, when you don't know, when you have doubt, you go to the people of the book.
But you don't
know. So I am the people of the book.
Yeah.
I will tell you what Allah knows.
You are the people of the book?
I will tell you what Allah knows.
What is the people of the book?
By your Lord, they will not truly believe until they make you judge concerning that over which they dispute among themselves. Then find within themselves no discomfort from what you have judged and summit in full submission. Definition of the Muslim people are the ones who submit to Allah and who submit to Muhammad in fullness. That is the Quran definition of Allah. Quran definition of Muslim people. And also, it is very easy to identify Muslim people today. Just turn on the TV, look at the yesterday news. What they did 20 years ago. Took the life of 3,000 people. Last 20 years, in the name of Allah, those people who scream out as Allah Akbar verses, took the life of approximately 40,000 people. That's what I say when I say Muslim people, that's whom I mean. Do you have a problem with them?
I don't think that it makes sense to call the religion followers people, no.
So you still want to justify and you still don't want to listen what I'm saying. That's absolutely up to you. But as you identify yourself as a humanist, by default, I'm guessing you don't believe in Allah. Mm-hmm. You don't believe in Muhammad. Mm-hmm. When Islam comes and takes over, watch out. Because they will come after you. They will come after all of us who do not accept Allah and Muhammad. They will come for all of us who doesn't accept Allah as God and who doesn't obey Muhammad. They will come for all of you. That even will be Mr. Policeman. And that will be people today who justifies that child marriage. Watch out, sir. Nothing is not going to help you on that day. Nothing is not going to help you on that day. Let me give you another beautiful reference for you. Who are the Muslim people? Muslim people. It is not for a believing man or a believing woman when Allah and His Messenger, someone who identifies themselves as a Muslim, when Allah and Mr. Muhammad pieces police and FBI upon him, when Allah and His Messenger have decided a matter that they should have no choice about their affair, and whoever disobeys Allah and His Messenger has certainly strayed into clear error. If you are Muslim, what makes you Muslim? Allah and Muhammad. Having full submission, having full obedience to their message. That makes you Muslim. So, at this stage, if you still have no problem with Mr. Muslims or people who follow the ideology of Islam, it is time for you to have problem now. Because you are still breathing, you could do something. You could stop next 9/11. You could stop next Mr. Muslims who are going to take the life of others. But for that, first the problem needs to be identified. And identifying problem does not mean simply coming alongside and saying, I am very proud that my prophet had a sex with a child. Or I will have sex with a child too. Those are the things that people are proud of. Shouldn't be proud of. And especially if you are living in UK, you shouldn't be proud of at all. Very much disturbing. Silent comes alongside of giving consent in this occasion, and that is already double disturbing.